These videos are a stream recording hybrid. Random commentary based on the stream chat may be found. Stupid GIFs found from the stream chat will also be found. Viewer discretion may be advised. Huh. Interesting.
Oh, hi.
I'm assuming this is you, right?
Polly, about this picture.
Oh, that's me when I was young.
Well, that's that.
What about it, Mr. Morgan?
Oh, nothing. Forget it.
Oh, it brings back memories. There was a Miss Greenvale contest in town, and I was so young and daring. I entered the contest, you see. It's embarrassing just thinking about it now.
There's nothing to be embarrassed about. You look beautiful in this picture.
Yes, yes. And the food was just wonderfully delicious.
So, Polly, where's the trophy?
Oh, Mr. Morgan, I never said that I became Miss Greenvale. There were no trophies for second place.
You mean this pretty girl in this picture was second place? So who won first place?
Are you serious, Mr. Morgan? It couldn't be more obvious. It was Sigourney.
Sigourney? The lady with the pot?
Really?
Now, she was beautiful. All the men in town were crazy about her. Well, of course, aside from my husband, that is. Oh, you should quit smoking, Mr. Morgan.
That's right, Polly.
Well, thanks for bringing back such a wonderful memory. I can't give you this picture, but please, take this instead.
Polly's pepper.
Now that's one story I won't be forgetting for a while.
Pure and beautiful. Okay. That's... okay. I was not expecting her to have, second place if she's even half as beautiful as York was making her out to be. I know that we're all standing here, George. Kind of want to see if you'll drive me somewhere like this. Nope. So guys, as you might have noticed, we decided to change up Emily's outfit. We felt like an entire episode being in one outfit was too much for her, and as such, she had to change outfits. Yeah. It also makes it really easy to tell if somehow a reverse peace sign appears on her back. I'm not treating you like suspects. I just realized there's a trading card behind the hotel, and I'm kind of an avid collector of them. I just heard something moving again. I swear there's squirrels in this town or something. Well, I know there's squirrels in this town, as Thomas had that entire thing about them, but you know what I mean. Wait, can you not get behind the hotel from there? Okay, I know I can get in via this. Grab that agent honor. But is there really... there's a post in the way here, right? Oh, no, you can not get past there, even though there's a bench there, meaning... whatever. Alright, is there any way into there from here? Can't squeeze through there because of invisible walls. And yes, I say avid, but I kind of mean obsessive compulsive? Yeah, that's a good term for obsessive compulsive collector. So all I have to do is run all the way around this building. Ooh, I can spy on people. Well, now that I'm done spying on people that weren't even there. I love having infinite ammo machine guns. Makes me feel powerful. And Forrest Kaysen. Got his card. Ooh. And there's spots to fish. I know I should be doing this during a rainy day or something, but I want to see what I can catch. Oh, it's not B? What is it? I got trash. Really? You caught a garbage. I caught one garbage. Yay. Well, that was interesting. Really? Well, I seem to have lost that bait. Looks like I was baited into losing a bait. Shut up. It was funnier in my head. Anything? Aha, got a fish. Caught a smallmouth bass. I will catch it because, you know, bass are always nice. Okay, try that again. Dang it. Okay, I think I know how to do this, so I'm gonna attempt to do it. Let's see if my math works and if I've done this right. Alright. Figured. Alright, this one should be a tug on the line. Got some bullets. Yay for me. Twelve gauge shotgun shells. Because that is the most useful thing. Alright, might have a bite this time. Oh, come on, I was one too far. Ah! I was really hoping to catch that present. I want to see what's in the present. I have to figure out what it is. Because if it's something really good, sweet. It could be like a trading card or a magical thing. I don't know what I'm on about. It's something. It's just 15 blocks after. Let this one pass. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. No, I think it was one too late. I had to do it a moment sooner. I swear, if the present is freaking more garbage, I'm gonna be quite upset. Alright. If I can just get this present, everything will be okay. Everything's gonna be okay. I did it too early. Oh, nope, I did it perfect. Yes! I got a Polly Oxford? Did I just really get a card? Really? I actually got a trading card for that. Let's see if there are any more presents here. If there isn't, then I'm just going to leave this spot. I'll either go fishing at the other spot, or I'll go and try to do side quest stuff. Alright, come on! Just a little bit more! I am best fishermen. I catch trash and a single fish. And bullets. I catch bullets with my fishing rod. And I sometimes even catch giant portraits of a present that actually has a card inside of it somehow. I didn't mean to do it then, but yeah, that present looks opened already, so. 10 millimeter auto bullets. Yeah, I don't need to do anything else here. It's 10:35 already. So I'm going to drop by this spot over here, see if there's anything else to fish, and if there is not, then I'm going to use my auto fast travel thing. That was a weird camera angle. I'm gonna try this again. It'd be so much faster with my other thing. Oh, hey. More bait. How nice. All right. Nope, it's the exact same. Well, I lost that bait because it went more than I thought it should have. I didn't mean to... Back out of this. Don't need to do any of this because I already have the gift that was there and I don't need more fish. Alright. Now let's go to Emily's house. I'm assuming that's where I need to go. Because that's where I found her last time. Okay, so it's not to my right. It is instead to my left down this road. It is literally right there. The fact that they give you a couple minutes to do this is kind of ridiculous. They also face you starting off the wrong direction. Which is another thing that's kind of ridiculous.
Why aren't we there yet? Could you step on it? If we go this slow, my pot is going to get cold.
No one wants that cold kush.
This is not good. It's losing more and more of its warmth. At this rate, my pot is going to get cold. Hurry! Hurry! Step on it! Why do you have to drive so safely? Can't you see my pot is getting cold? This is not good. It's losing more and more.
Okay, we're here already.
At this rate, my pot is going to get cold.
You're insane, we get it. We just saved you, like, 10 minutes of walking, or 15 minutes of walking, or something.
Oh, thanks to you, my pot is still warm.
I'm glad to hear that.
Don't get so excited, will you? Keep your voice down.
What, are you going to tell me a secret?
The pot knows everything. Hears all.
It's just like the coffee.
If you can't find the person you are looking for, you need to look at things from a different angle. There is only one truth, but more than one is always visible. Like cooking a stew. Mix things in and wait for it to boil together. Just make sure it doesn't get burnt, and keep an eye on it. You have to gently mix it sometimes and wait until it's ready. Listen carefully. The best stew is a stew that is boiled slowly.
You got roaming Sigourney.
Sigourney? Oh my pot is getting cold again! Did you have to talk so long? Oh.
Okay, cold pot one is finished. We have to drive for other places, apparently. Or from other places. Apparently. Eh.
Sam, we need to go to Muse's gallery.
I know where.
George said to take the road along the lake and go north.
Okay. That was like... That was like a freaking raining turn. Seriously, it's like the... It's like unless you're going slow, it's completely pointless to use the... What's it called?
Zach, Don't you think there are a lot of good-looking women in this
Drift,
town?
That's the term I'm looking
like
for.
It's like heaven compared to the town we grew up in. Do you remember Liz? Prom queen? Elizabeth Scott Moore. She could be royalty with a name like that. But you know, she was like an actress from a B-movie, wasn't she? Bleached blonde hair, too much makeup, clothes showed off her cleavage, and that mole by her mouth.
Say, Zach, were you with me back then?
You know, that mole was me.
Just skip the rest of it. Let's hope I don't have to listen to that again. I think I've ever heard it before, so I don't need to hear it again. The Ingrid. Oh, right there behind me. I was going the right way the entire time. Wow, that looked like it was actually on purpose, which it totally wasn't. I thought it was a pretty nice parking job. I don't know what you're talking about.
Zach, is there something here that you want to check out?
Well, the gallery closes at 1700. But there's no real reason to hurry. We need to pace ourselves for an investigation.
Ah, there you are. You came at a good time, son. I've got to hear more about the Raincoat Killer. Don't rush. Rush on the battlefield to get you killed. If you don't want to die, son, you should be methodical.
Well, even though there's a huge amount of scrap metal.
Son, you must be the only guy to see scrap when you look at those treasures. Look more carefully. Right there, just in front of you, that is what you're looking for. Come on, a car. There's still plenty of parts that can be used. Son, if you're ready to get your hands dirty, you should find useful parts for your car. What do you think?
Sure, but first I want to talk to you.
Now then, young fella. How do you feel about your current vehicle?
My vehicle? It's a piece of crap, but I'm not here to talk about that.
Then how about a little treasure hunt? Listen up, young man. My junkyard is actually a mountain of treasure. All kinds of treasure lies in those mountains of junk. The problem is, there's so many, I've lost track of where everything is. You've caught on already. I can see it in your eyes. I need you to head out in the yard and find certain things for me. If you help me out, I'll customize your car a little.
What are you talking about?
Didn't I tell you to shut up and listen to your superiors? Now, will you do it or not?
I don't see any reason to refuse.
Well said. First, I'll need some low gear parts. With that, I'll be able to boost the engine of your car. You'll find one around E5. Go! Don't just stand there, get going!
E5 would be considered the bottom right corner, I believe. So if I go to the... Okay. E is right there. 5 is right here. So it's not the bottom right. It doesn't use that kind of logic. So, just need to get around these fences. Wasn't there a fence in my way over here? Or am I just imagining it? Oh, that's why. I can get through right here. And now, I just head to 5. Let's see, E is right here. 5 is right over here. I really have to head all the way around this? I couldn't just climb over a car or something? York has a weird way of doing things. Now, E5. I thought you said to be here. Oh. Right over here. Low gear parts. Now you just have to run all the way back really fast. Hey, General, what's up? You need this? You probably need this.
This will save your life someday, son.
You sure know how to exaggerate?
You imbecile. Engine boost is vital for bringing back soldiers alive from war.
Engine boost?
Of course. Engine boost is the basis of everything.
Let me tell you a war story, son. I was leading my unit at the very front line.
Things were bad, and sanitary conditions were worse. Endless guerrilla attacks were stripping us of our manpower. Everyone was tired to their limits.
There was one sergeant who really rubbed me the wrong way. The boys liked to call him Crybaby Timothy. He really gave me headaches, I can tell you.
How?
Just by breathing. His posture was bad. He was weak, slow, easily distracted. I have no idea who thought he was capable of combat in a war zone. He endangered the lives of every member of the unit. Stomach pains. The worst stomach ache ever. Every one of us. It was just cooking. He was using food that was contaminated. I flew into the dugout toilet like an Apache chopper returning to base. I have to tell you, it was a close call. My engine was boosting. And that's what got me there safely, right in the nick of time.
What happened to the unit?
You really want to know? It was a terrible sight. Powerful, athletic men reduced to walking dead, blinking like crazy, shaking with pain. Their confidence and self-esteem were all crushed. They almost didn't recover.
An interesting story.
So you see the need for engine boost now, do you? I'll keep my side of the promise and get to work on your vehicle.
Okay. That's weird.
That badge on him is for a sergeant. Looks like it was sewn on something else before it was sewn onto his shirt. I wonder what that's all about.
I put in longer pistons and optimized your lower gears. That should add boost to your speed when you accelerate. But there's still plenty of stuff I can do to make your car go faster. Just come see me again and I'll customize your car a little more.
Low gear parts completed. I wonder if he can do any more of this now. He cannot, but I can still try to buy things from him. Wait, I can just buy people's cars? Okay. That's weird. Now let's see how fast it goes.
We need to go to Muse's gallery. George said to take the road along the lake and go north.
Nah, it doesn't seem to be going faster. Maybe this isn't technically my car or something?
To recap, the movie was the fourth sequel in a series that started in 1978.
That's right, Zach. It was Superman 4, The Quest
for
Peace.
Oh, I never saw that
one. Lex Luthor was back. It was played by Gene Hackman. That alone made it a must for all us fans. I don't remember much more about it, though. I'm sure there was more trivia about it. Still, forget 4. Richard Donner directing 1 and 2. Now those two were great movies. And Christopher Reeve really shined as Superman.
Actually, Zach, I've got a confession to make.
Promise not to tell anyone because I'd be really embarrassed. I actually like the first two Superman movies more than the first two Star Wars movies. I think John Williams did a better job with the theme song for Superman. But whenever I try to hum it, It always turns into the Star Wars song somewhere along the way.
I know it's strange, Zach. I know. So, Zach, which Richard Donner film do you like the best?
No need to hurry. Take some time and think it over.
I can go take care of the... Let's see. Stuff to take care of... Oh! There are quests from the Forest Keeper's cabins. So I have a few places I can go. If I head up here and keep traveling along here, I think. No, this isn't the right place. Alright, let's get going again. This time via fast travel, because I need to go make up for lost time in the hospital. I don't think I went to the right place. I think it was... whatever. I literally just went right here. Like I was saying originally. I went to Becky's house instead of the general hospital. Now while I'm here, I'm going to check to make sure I can't just shoot this open. Try this again. No, you can't reach it from this angle. Pull up my wrench because I honestly like my wrench the most. And head inside to the Greenvale Hospital. I'm gonna assume that he's in his office, which is... actually, it is this direction. It's through these sets of doors. Straight down this way. Right before you head into these last doors, you take a right, though. And here he is, Usha.
Hey there.
Proving my knowledge of everything here. Yeah. Talk to you. Skip by this cutscene because I don't need to do it, like, read it all again. I mean, I've heard this already. Talk to him instantly.
Hey there.
Talk to him again.
It's a question.
Vertically. Usha's potato chips.
Thanks, Usha.
Usha's potato chips. Apparently I can't pronounce words. Now? I don't know any other side missions that I can do. Let's see. Isaiah and... it's almost the same name. It's Isaiah and... Isical? I don't know. I don't know his name. The two kids who talked to me that one time. Okay, Isaiah and Isaac. They are right there. The nearest location that I can fast travel to would be... the graveyard I haven't been to. Or the junkyard. So, fast travel to the junkyard real quick. And sure, Lily, if you get the wall of text from Ryan, I would really appreciate it. Okay, if I go right here and up this way, it's the right way. Okay.
Zach, we need to go to Muse's gallery. George said to take the road along the lake and go north.
I know what George said, but I don't really care about what George said. It doesn't actually affect me in any way. Wee-oo.
I went to see every Richard Donner movie on the day they premiered. Every single one. Goonies. Lost Boys. The Lethal Weapon series. But my favorite has to be Lady Hawk.
Lady Hawk's not a movie I've seen.
1985. The same year as Goonies. Both Rutger Hauer and Michelle Pfeiffer really shine in that one. But more than anything, it's the story setting that was really good. A love story about a cursed knight that changes into a wolf at night, and a cursed maiden that changes into a hawk during the day.
Very romantic. Don't you think so, Zach?
They can only be...
Crap, I accidentally... I wanted to check the thing, but I accidentally skipped his dialogue. Yeah, it's down here. I shouldn't have doubted myself, and doubting myself, I lost myself the ability to listen to that. Because I actually do like listening to those. York has interesting dialogue. But sadly, I missed it. Because I'm an idiot. I'm not actually sure what an idiot is, but I know people who say idiot. So, I'm just gonna go and say it's probably something like an idiot. Driving up this hill. I thought they were just open. Oh yeah, they are open. Hey Isaiah, I heard you have a quest for me. That isn't in your angel form. I don't like having to study. I don't like doing math. But we'll study hard so we can meet the goddess again. If we study hard, we'll be able to meet her again. Why do you think that?
We saw someone. We really did.
Isaac? Isaiah? What exactly did you see?
Someone in the forest.
Standing under Anna's tree.
Not a goddess.
A little different.
A ghost?
Yeah, maybe it was a ghost.
Ghost? What makes you think that?
We found this on the ground there.
Would a ghost drop this?
Out of focus picture of lesbians. Great.
Let me see. It's blurry and out of focus. I can make out two people, but not their faces. So that's why they think it was a ghost. But then who was under Anna's tree?
Well, that looks like Anna and maybe Diane? I'm going to say that Diane was Anna's lesbian lover. Alright, we're going to save the game here real quick. And because I don't actually know how long this has been going, next time, let's play Deadly Premonition the Director's Cut. I think next time is going to be the last episode of this recording session for me. Seriously, it sounds like someone's running away every time I step out the door. It's driving me insane. But like I was saying, I'm going to do this last recording, this next one, and then I'm going to be done for tonight. I've been playing this game for probably around, 10 hours?
Zach, we need to go to Muse's gallery.
And that's, honestly, 10 hours of streaming. Lake and go north. So, yeah, I'm a wee bit tired. It hasn't been, completely all the time, because I've been stolen by my family a few times. So, I have to be fair about that. But it's been hours upon hours upon hours, so, you know, I'll see you guys next time.